Welcome back, everyone, to another PT Pro from the Optimal Body Podcast. I'm Dr. Dom.
I'm Doc Jen.
And today we're going to be talking about elastic tape. It's kind of like that KT tape or the rock tape that you'll see on athletes, look all fancy, making designs. What does it do? Is it helping us? What does the research say? What do they claim that it does? Tune in.
Thanks for joining us again on another PT Pearl. So we're talking into elastic tape, better known as kinesiology tape, kinesio tape, KT tape, rock tape. I'm sure there's other brands out there.
Yeah.
But you know, that fancy, colorful, beautiful tape that a lot of athletes wear. You might see them a lot in sport games, volleyball games. I mean, almost anything across the board, I feel like a lot of athletic wear.
I think when the colors came around, it probably came that much more popular.
Oh, yeah.
Because the nude colored and the black colored tape wasn't doing it on TV. So once they started showing like bright pink and orange KT tape or rock tape, like all over people's
all different
backs
designs
and shoulders and all these designs, then everyone out there was like, ooh, what's that? I want to put that on when I play.
Well, and I think it just feeds into that perception of if an athlete or someone I admire who's incredible at what they do is wearing this, then that must mean that it's effective and I should wear it so it enhances my performance, right?
Yes.
I mean, this is why we put athletes on cereal boxes. Well, if they're going to eat this cereal, I want to eat this cereal. I mean, it's the
totally
same thing.
That's why I still eat Wheaties. As Michael Jordan told me too when I was a kid.
I want to like start and just put a little disclosure. We're not going to talk about a specific brand. We might mention certain brands, but we're not attacking any brand or putting any brand down. You know, they're all for us under the umbrella of the same elastic tape. What we're told it's doing, right, is reducing pain, improving movement and improving your sense and all this stuff. And it's said to really lift the skin and decompress the fascia, which we know that we have many layers of fascia. I mean, we talk about this more in Jill's podcast, I believe, episode 22. I think I know that one. Jill
nice.
Miller.
Nice.
Go listen to her about fascia. And it allows the lymphatic fluids to move a little bit more so that we can start to reduce waste in the area and reduce like bacteria and all that kind of stuff. But is it really doing any of those things?
Likely not. At least like likely that's not likely the reason we might feel a difference from it, or that's probably not the reason that, oh, it's improving my lymphatic flow and my joint has more space to move and I don't have as much pain now. Probably not the case as much as this tape is touching our skin, right? We have all these receptors in our skin. It's kind of like if we bump our knee and we put our hands around it.
We hit
the funny bone and we rub it and put our hand on it. We're touching all these receptors, these mechanoreceptors in our skin that kind of helps us then gate the pain. We activate these larger fibers that tell our brain, oh, we've got some pressure around that area. We have something kind of tugging on the skin in that area. And that almost masks pain a little bit. So some people might just like this tape on them because, hey, that little sensation that I get from the tape tugging on my skin helps my pain a little bit.
I think a lot of people, when they think about this elastic power of a tape, they're thinking it's holding something into place. It's elastic, so as I pull from one end to the other end, or like my shoulder, right? I'm going to take it from my chest and then wrap it around to the back of my shoulder blade, and it's going to help to hold my shoulder back. Well, that elasticity only lasts about 20 minutes, if that.
Yeah.
20 minutes. And then what, right? We're walking around with this all through practice, all through a game.
For multiple days, people will put it on and say, just leave it on for 2 or 3 days until it falls off.
Yeah. That right? is a lot of the recommendation, actually, which shouldn't be.
Some of the things that it said that research shows it doesn't help is like ankle stability for lateral ankle sprains, or, you know, for shoulder dislocations, helping keep your shoulder in socket, or pull in a certain way that's going to help support. Like, again, probably not as much the case.
And not at all. I mean, think about where you're putting this tape on. You're putting it on the skin. The skin moves. I can pick up my skin and move it side to side, right? Because I have this superficial fascial layer. So I have give already to my fascial layer on the skin itself. And so if I'm putting tape on to move the skin, all I'm doing is moving skin. That's all I'm doing. I'm not putting it on a tendon, on a bone, on a muscle, and then moving it. So because tape is so superficial, we cannot think that it's actually going to hold something into place or change the way that our muscle or our structure is really responding. And so that's like the number one overarching thing I think we have to understand about the tape.
Personally, when I use like any versions of these elastic tapes, like, because we've read things that said basically it doesn't provide any neurophysiologic like effect for
enhancing
athletic performance. Right. Great and when I read that, I'm like, okay, I can understand that for enhancing, like, it's not going to make us jump higher, it's not going to make us run faster. But I feel like the times when I've worn it, whether it has been around my knee or been around my shoulder or something, I don't know. I think there's that little bit of a psychological thing for me. And again, whether it's a placebo or whether it is just a little bit of that pain relief combined with me being a little more aware of that area, I don't know. In cases that I've used it, I have felt benefit, or like, hey, it's helping me be a little more aware of what's going on in my shoulder as I play frisbee or as I'm doing this. So this is where, as we say all these things like, oh, it doesn't provide any benefit for lateral ankle sprains, does that mean that if you've been dealing with ankle sprains and you find that when you make this amazing pattern on your leg with elastic tape, it helps you, or you feel more confident on your leg when you're playing? Go ahead and do it. Like, it doesn't mean, you know, abandon anything just because we're here saying like, oh, the research says it doesn't make any difference. But if you find a difference, like, it could be beneficial for you to do that for a short amount of time while, again, you're training other things.
My goal, I would say, is I want you to understand why you're using it. And I think that's important, because then we get the fear of, well, now I can't do performance without it, right? And we fall into that fear aspect of not having the tape available, which your body has you. You know, your body's strong and supportive. And as long as we continue to train it that way, then you're good. You're training for something and your coach comes over and touches you and puts some, like, gives you feedback. Yeah. That's feedback into your body, right? And so touch is feedback. And so if you have this tape that's going to provide that proprioceptive touch to allow you to understand where your body is in space, then it can help in that aspect short term. It's not long term though. Again, why this isn't like something that you need to be wearing all the time 24/7 to really help improve anything. That's not the reality of what KT tape is, or kinesiology tape. I don't want to just keep using one brand. They did test different types of tape and they did find, so this is my one shout out to Rock Tape, plus I took the course, so I'm a little biased. However, this was the Rock Tape found that it improved joint sense, not only at end range of motion, so like moving your shoulder all the way back, right? And having that improved proprioception in that end range of motion, but even mid range. So as you're moving through, it helped improve that proprioception around that area. So could that help? Especially, I would say it's more beneficial as you're rehabbing. Like, if you're using it in conjunction with improving strength and movement patterns, just so that you start to build awareness of the space around you. But if you don't need it, you don't need it. I don't think it's necessary in rehabbing. I personally don't. Another important thing, we can't look at it as a standalone treatment. So say you go get worked on, right? And then you're heading out the door and they say, oh, let me put this KT tape on to help hold in place what I just did for you or something.
Yeah.
And then don't give you any exercises or don't give you anything. I would say if that's your standalone treatment walking out the door, that's not good. It's not going to really make a difference in anything, really. And they did find that there was a study that was done looking at using kinesiology tape as a standalone treatment in chronic low back pain. And because it was, again, a standalone, meaning you're not doing any exercise, you're not doing any rehab on top of it, it really didn't improve pain or disability at all. If it helps someone to walk and move better as they're exercising, is that bad?
As we're increasing, I mean, if we can bring down somebody's osteoarthritis in their knee and get them more active and gain them more tolerance before they start feeling pain, then maybe when we take the KT tape off or the elastic tape off, they might not feel pain as early or as quickly or as severely. So again, great tool to use potentially along someone's rehab journey, along someone's healing journey.
We also don't even have good evidence that it's reducing swelling. Yeah. So no matter how many fancy techniques you want to use to make all those crazy designs, It's just mainly stimulating the receptors in our skin and our in the way that we feel, and then our sense of that area.
We don't want to crap on the KT tape or anything, or the rock tape. There are applications of this just like any other intervention, but we just have to do it thoughtfully and not think it's going to be the one fix for us.
And I just want to end with, now that you understand that it's not holding something into place, the tighter that you pull on that tape, it doesn't equate to the better. All that's going to do is irritate the skin a little bit more.
For sure.
So I would take a rock tape course if you're really interested in how to use this and why to use it. However, it's like a little tiny elastic pull, and then just place it down on the skin. It's literally like the tiniest little pull, and then lay it on the skin. There's not a big tug, because then you're just going to irritate your skin. Thanks for joining us again and listening to our little rant on tape. Hopefully you understand when to use it, why it's effective, and when it might not be as helpful. If you have more questions or recommendations, things you want to learn about, or tools that you use that you haven't understood why you're using it, drop it below, comment, let us know, and don't forget to subscribe so you don't miss out on any future ones.